I was sentenced to over 1,000 years in prison for a crime that I committed. I got out in March of this year after doing 27 years. Didn't I say I was guilty? I was guilty of some very horrible things. And I'm not glorifying that, but I have to tell you that to let you know what God did in my life. While I was inside that hell, God had angels unawares even in there. They placed me beside a lady named Margie Velma Barfield that was on death row. And this lady was a true Christian. Well, I didn't know nothing about Christians or, you know, these were just people. They was foreigners to me. And she prayed Jesus. She loved Jesus. She sang Jesus. She read Jesus in that cell. And I got so angry and I said, don't you know, God ain't going to save you. They're going to kill you. You're on death row. Don't nobody care nothing about that. Man ain't going to never forgive you. They don't care. And if God is so good, why don't he get you out of it? You know, that was my attitude because I didn't know the Lord. She just prayed for me. Said, honey, I'm praying for you. And I said, oh, praying for me. I watched her. Because if you watch somebody long enough, they're going to slip. So I'm watching her, and I said, oh, she going to, after a while, and I'm going to get her then. But she never slipped. And something began to happen in my life. I wanted what she had. A guilty, miserable, wretched person like me. I wanted what she had. They did execute her. But you know what? She wasn't sad. She said she had fought a good fight. I began to call on the God of Miss Margie's. Didn't know lightning's happening, no thundering, but something strange. I knew that he heard me. I knew God heard me. And I said, God, save me. Help me. It didn't happen right then. But immediately when I picked up my Bible, it went to a verse that said, if you bring your gift to the altar and there remember that your brother have aught against you, leave your gift, go and correct your wrong, then I will come and receive you. I was like, no, I can't do that. Nah, yeah. I'm already in prison with over 1,000 years. Nobody else knew, but God knew. See, we can think we're hiding something from somebody else, but God knows it all. And what I had done, ladies and gentlemen, was I had lied on two innocent men that was on death row. Two innocent men. And God was telling me that I needed to go back and correct that. And that wasn't easy. But I did. Only in God's strength and believing in him. How many of you know it's a price? I never thought I was supposed to get out of prison, and I never were. Freedom, I'd never see it again. But I was free on the inside. I was free on the inside. It is truly true. Those that God, whom he set free, they are free indeed. Couldn't no bars hold me on the inside. And I just praised and I just thanked him. And so when they came to me and they said, Betty, I think we're going to send you to honor grade. I said, you must have made a mistake because I got too much time. I know I'm not going anywhere. And I was okay with it. I didn't believe it for about a week. But see, that was God moving in my life. And having been gone so long out of society, this world has changed tremendously. I don't even know how to work the little remote control. I'm still learning that one. But more than anything, the same way God placed those angels in my life through Miss Marge Velma Barfield, coming out of prison, he has placed angels unawares in my life. Carmel Baptist Church gave me a chance. Oh, I went to school while I was in prison. You can take college courses. I have about 5 degrees. But Carmel Baptist gave me a chance to reintegrate with society. I wash every dish in their kitchen, and I praise God every day. Because it's a miracle that man, us, we would forgive someone like me. But we couldn't if you didn't know Jesus. You are all Jesus to me. I can stand up and I can tell my testimony. It can go on and on and on. But what you need to know is it is so many ordinary people just like you who give me courage, who give me strength, and make me want to keep on keeping on doing the right thing, because I see Jesus Christ in you. I see forgiveness in you. I see love in you. I see a second chance in you. And I'm thankful that there are true Christians like you here at Carmel Baptist. Now, I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I want to do a little bit of prejudice here. And it says, I am God's woman, hear me roar, with numbers too big to ignore. And I know too much to go back to pretend, because I've heard it all before, and I've been down there on the floor. No one's ever, no Satan's not gonna keep me down again. Yes, I am wise. I am wisdom born of pain. Yes, I paid the price, but look how much I've gained. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. I am strong. I am invincible. I am woman. You can bend but never break me, because it only serves to make me more determined to achieve God's final goal. And I'll come back even stronger, not a novice any longer, because God deepens the conviction in my soul. Yes, I am wise. I am wisdom born of pain. Yes, I've paid the price, but look how much I've gained. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. He's more than wonderful than my heart can believe. He goes beyond my highest hopes and fondest dreams. He's everything that my soul ever longed for, everything he promised, and so much more. More than amazing, more than marvelous, he's more than wonderful. That's what Jesus is. You know, it says in the Bible, be ready to give an account of the hope that you have in you.